Hello students, my name is Vinay and as you know, today we are going to talk about a very important topic in your exam of TSPSC, and that is Indian society, right? So in this lecture which we are going to discuss, basically all the components, what is the syllabus and how we are going to discuss this in the future, right, in the coming lectures, right? So what you are going to do in this specific lecture is we are going to discuss the syllabus properly, because you need to understand that it is this syllabus which we have to focus. This is the thing which is demanded in the exam, so we have to study this much only, but in complete detail. So even if they can ask any question, we'll be able to discuss that properly, right? So what we are going to do is we are going to discuss this syllabus one by one, right, which will help us to, you know, perform better, right, in the exam, right? So the first thing that is here is what they are saying is salient features of Indian society, right? They are talking about the salient features of Indian society. What we are going to do is we are going to talk about every topic, precisely, concisely in today's lecture, and then I'll be elaborating that topic when we'll be actually discussing that topic in the coming lecture, right? Now say, first thing is there, we need to understand that in this subject, actually what we are going to do is we are going to talk about ourselves only. Like, see, even before discussion of the syllabus, I would like to tell you something about us. Like, when I say I am someone, that I am Vinay, who am I actually? Is it sufficient that I say that I am Vinay? Does that define me completely? Let's do one exercise, small exercise we will do, and we will try to, you know, make sure that, okay, how we are, a layered personality. Right. Say, for example, if I say this is me, right, and this me actually it consists of lot of things. Say, for example, I belong to a particular caste. That makes me different from every other person who belongs to a different caste. Right. I belong to a specific religion. Now, when I say caste, you will say, okay, sir, by default, I belong to Hindu religion. But trust me, that cannot be the case, because, this caste system is so entrenched in the Indian society that it has also is part of other religions too. So a Sikh person can also be having a caste, right? So if you belong to a specific religion, you are apart from all those who are from different religion. You can be from different class. Now again, this is a kind of status symbol, we understand this class is like when we say that if you are belonging to a family of a class one government servant, or a rich family if you belong to, then your class is different, right? Your choices are different. Your dressing patterns, your food choices, the shops you go for shopping is different. The amount of money you can spend changes. The locations you visit for your vacation changes. So, and we understand this. For example, let me tell you, for this lecture, I traveled by train yesterday. So even when we travel in train, what we have different classes, right? We have one general class. Right, then we have sleeper, or second class is general class, then we have sleeper, then we have AC class, in that too we have this third AC, second AC, first AC, right? So according to the ability of person to pay to railways, they give you or they offer you a class, and the kind of service changes, right? So the class you belong to, actually normally class is a word which is associated with the income, but that is not the only thing, right? If you are earning good amount of money but you stay in village or city, again that is a differentiation, that you belong to village or city. ठीक है, आर यू रिच बिकॉज यूर पेरेंट्स आर रिच और यू हैव बिकम रिच बिकॉज यू आर पार्ट ऑफ से फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई टी इंडस्ट्री एंड यू स्टार्टेड अर्निंग गुड अमाउंट ऑफ मनी, नाउ यू हैव बॉट 2-3 फ्लैट्स इन हैदराबाद, राइट, समथिंग लाइक दैट. So your class is a completely different thing, like it's a status symbol, right? You know, we kind of show off that we talk about, like you go to marriages and or you know any social event and you try to, you know, wear some branded clothes. So brand itself is a part of this class system. You want to show off that I have wear the shirt of Mufti, right? So this is what class is all about, which is completely different from caste or religion. Any person belong to different religion with good economic or financial condition can afford the things, right? And we can find, you know, different class people in the same religion, right? So for example, if I am traveling in a train and they, like I am Hindu and someone who is belonging to general class is also Hindu, right? So both we are Hindus, but our class is different, right? Both we are Hindus, but our caste is different. Both we are Indian, but our religion might be different, right? So we are sitting side by side in a train, but one is Muslim, other is Christian, I am Hindu, right? At the same time, he is Christian, but he is very rich. I am Hindu, but I am a middle class. I am a Muslim, but I belong to a lower class. That might be the case, right? So, what I am trying to tell you, when we walk down in society, even though I look at a person and you know, trust me, but we too judge people. Like if a lady comes and crosses me, I look at her. So within seconds, I judge her. What I judge? I judge her age. Say for example, she is like in her 40s. So I am like, okay, she is in her 40s. She might be having 2 children. Okay, she is wearing sari and mangalsutra. So I am like, okay, she is married and she is a Hindu woman with maybe 1 or 2 children. And she is like in her 40s. And she is a homemaker maybe. Right? If somebody else is there, I can say now, I think she is a working woman. If somebody else is there, I am like, okay, I think she is a Muslim woman because she might have a different dress code altogether, right? If there is one more woman, I can say, I think she is a rural woman. She has come to this urban area, maybe at her relative's place or some different work, but she does not look urban, right? We differentiate between the people from village and urban, right? We differentiate them based on the toning of their speaking, the cloths they wear, the choices they have, maybe we speak good English and they are not able to converse in English. So we, you know, try to judge them, right? So all these things are there. So whether I belong to a village or urban area, that defines me. Then what defines me is the family I belong to. Now whether this family is nuclear or whether this family is extended family. Extended means joint family. So nuclear family is a simple term, like I, like my father, mother and me and my sister or brother or some other siblings, if stay together, then that's a nuclear family. But if we stay with other people too, say for example my uncle and his wife and something like that, if we are staying together with their children, then we can call it an extended family or joint family in India, right? So whether I belong to nuclear family or joint family, whether that family is in village or in city, right, all these things actually defines me. Then uske baad, like after that, there are other issues too. Like I have just discussed this based on few criterias, but there can be other things too, right? If we consider few other things, the language I speak, right, the region I belong to, which language I speak, right, or which region I belong to. Now I am not saying state here, I am saying region, because region is more concrete than even state. Say for example, I am belonging to Maharashtra, but I belong to the western part of Maharashtra. Somebody might be in from Vidarbha region in Maharashtra, somebody might be from Konkan region of Maharashtra, right? So based on the, you know, language, choices, cultural patterns, dialects, where you belong changes. So region can be different, language can be different. For example, if you are in Delhi, for your competitive exam preparation, then these differences are strike. If you are in your own region, then most of the people are like you. Like they belong to your religion, maybe they belong to your caste, maybe they belong to your class, right? Some differences are there, but these differences does not appear so much. But if you are in a different place altogether, and if you suddenly notice a person speaking the same language that you are speaking, then you feel that kind of closeness to him or her, right? Then, yeah, obviously, gender, when I say him or her, male or female, that makes a difference, a lot of difference in a society like India, right? So the region, language, gender, caste, religion, class, village, family, and there are many other layers too. I am just discussing this as an example, right? What I am trying to tell you is this, that in this subject, we are going to discuss about these things which actually made me what I am today. I get birth, and the same day a caste is stuck with me. The family in which I am born, the class is stuck to me. Language which I am going to learn is obviously from the family. I learn my mother tongue, right? So if I born in Telangana, then obviously there are higher chances that Telugu is a language which I am going to learn, right? So as soon as I get birth, as soon as I come in this world, there are lots of these things get associated with me. Am I male, female? Based on that, people start judging. Now, you know, even today in India, son preference is there. They think that son will, you know, give liberation to us, so we want son. Now things are changing slowly, and people also are, you know, giving equal status to, you know, a girl child. But still there is that hidden demand that if it's a boy, it's good. It's good for all. It's the end. Now nobody will discuss. Even if you are a girl child, your parents will force you to have one more child, and they will end their desire only when you will have a boy child. So something like that is there, still there in the Indian society. So what I am trying to tell you is this. Now we can just see all this in a completely different thing. So let's see this in the same me. Can be discussed in this way. Say, if there is this me, I belong to this caste, the same me, I belong to this. Okay, we didn't discuss education. Education is also one more criteria which differentiate me from others. If I am an engineer, I feel proud that I am engineer. If I am doctor, I feel proud that I am doctor, and I am apart or different from others. When I see in a social gathering, when I sit down there, I don't actually show off every time, but I feel good about myself that everybody else is recognizing me and respecting me as a doctor, right? So this same me may belong to a specific language speaking group, right? This same me belong to different class. This same me actually belong to city or village. So, you know, this is just another diagram explaining the same concept which I tried to explain in the earlier diagram. So what I'm trying to tell you through all this is, in this subject, what we are going to do actually is we are going to talk about us. We are going to talk about us as an individual as well as a group, as a society. Now see, we really become part of something even without, you know, they don't ask us. Do somebody asked me that, do you really want this caste or do you really want to become part of some different caste? In fact, why we are talking about caste? Because we are born in India. Now caste system is integral part of Hindu social system, right? Now as I told you, it also have penetrated in other religions too. Like even today in India, we have Muslim caste, caste in Sikhism, caste in Christianity too, right? But for example, if you are born in Europe, then no caste is attached to you. If you are born in Russia, no caste is attached to you. If you are born in Nigeria, no caste is attached to you. But now that you are born in India, even without your consent, a caste is given to you, and as you born with that caste, you have to die with that caste. You can't change your caste. That's the reality. Now, don't you think this is something which you really have to think about? Because you never asked for any caste, but now it has been stuck with you. Right? Many times I used to feel that, my God, like when there was a time when English as a language was difficult to speak, and I used to feel very underconfident. So I used to see those people who speak very fluent English. When I visited Delhi, I used to see, you know, girls of college of Delhi University used to speak fluent English, even when they used to travel in bus. So I used to feel, wow, why I did not born to such a family with such an elite class where English used to be a common language, and why I, you know, was born in some family where only my mother tongue was taught to me. So you feel something like this, but trust me, you don't have a choice. So many things are actually imposed on us, right? And what we are going to discuss, or what we are going to do in this subject, that we are going to talk about us, why we are like this, you know, when we are going to discuss about us in the coming lectures, you will come to know how hypocritic we are. We say something and we do something. We talk about equality, we say that equal opportunity should be given to everybody, but at the same time we know that caste differences still prevail in the society. We say that child labor is a crime, but all of us, including the President of India, know that still today child labor persists in India. We know that human trafficking is not only crime, but it's a sin. It's something which can shake our inner conscience, but still it is happening even today in India. The small girl children are still sold, and you know, they are trapped in the rackets of prostitution, and it is still happening today. There are lots of diversity in India, so there are lots of diversity of problems in India. And really, we are diverse people. Let's talk about diversity. That is the first actually topic here. Like they are saying, what are the salient features? What are the salient features of Indian society? So the first salient features of Indian society is its diversity only. That's why we are going to discuss about the diversity. Now see, actually, if we really want to give other name to Indian society, that is diversity. Trust me. Like, we are so different from each other that our difference only defines us. Like, for example, if you go to a country like Finland, where more than 90% people belong to one religion, even though they have different sects or different belief system within that religion only, but more or less they belong to same religion. Their language, more or less, say for example, you go to France, 90% people speak French only, right? Most of their religion is same. They don't have caste. There is a class, obviously, because see, no society can be equal. No society can be equal. So there will be a kind of inequality based on money, based on status, right? They might have different status. Here we have caste as a status symbol. If I am a Brahmin, I am at the top level of the caste system. If I am, you know, Dalit, I am at the bottom level of the caste system. But in France, they might have some different status symbols, right? But still, a European country, most of them are Christian, their language is most of the times is same. They don't have a caste system, right? In India, everything is different. Trust me, India should be called not as a nation, but nation of nations. You go to 50 kilometers and things change in India. The dialect change. Can you imagine? Just let's talk about, you know, few examples of Indian diversity. Say, if we talk about language, देर आर अबाउट 1652 डायलेक्ट्स एंड लैंग्वेजेस आर स्पोकन इन इंडिया. कैन यू इमेजिन दिस? एज वी टॉक टूडे, दीज मेनी लैंग्वेजेस पीपल यूज टू कम्युनिकेट देयर फीलिंग्स एंड एक्सप्रेशंस, राइट? So we have this linguistic diversity, and this diversity is not enough, but we have linguistic nationalism too. If you go to Tamil Nadu, the people in Tamil Nadu are so much proud of their language that they will actually consider an outsider as an outsider, and they will never treat him like, most of the times, like I am not judging them or I am not criticizing them for that, but we have things like that, right? So even though we say that India is one country and we can travel from any part of country to any part and we can recite there Article 19, we know, but still there is this feeling that no, this is our language and we are very proud of this language. And we know that how in India, in the starting phase after independence, when Hindi, when North Indian leaders really wanted to impose Hindi as a national language, then what kind of movements actually emerged, and so the decision has to cancel. So we know all this. So based on language, there are lots of language people speak, and lots of diversity is there. Then there is diversity based on religion. So we have major dominant religion as Hindu religion, then we have Islam, then we have Christianity, then we have Sikhism, then we have Parsi or Zoroastrian, we call them, then we have Buddhist, then we have Jain. So these major seven religions are there in India, right? Total seven religion which are actually recognized by the state. There might be few Jews and few other religion people too, but these seven religions are there, and today these seven religions together stay in India, not with harmony, I would say. Every time there are fights between two, and comes, as I told you initially, that diversity which defines Indian society. So as we have a lot of diversity, we have lot of diversity of problems with this diversity, right? So communalism is one such problem. We know that this communalism brings a lot of violence, right? In country like India, before independence and after independence, there were so many communal violence that sometimes we really need to ask ourselves, are we Indian first or are we Hindu or Muslim first? But then the truth is that even today there are communal clashes, lots of communal clashes throughout India, right? So we have diversity on the basis of religion, then we have diversity on the basis of caste again. Now trust me, in India we have so many castes we cannot even imagine. Many governments before, even during British period also they tried, and after independence also they tried to, you know, make a list of all the castes, but there are so many, it is almost impossible to enumerate all of them. It is very difficult, right? So we have diversity on the basis of caste throughout India. We have diversity on the basis of language, religion, caste. Then we have diversities on the basis of region, right? So you might have heard about a political party named MNS in Maharashtra, right? Earlier it was Shiv Sena, now it is MNS, which actually tried to target North Indians. North Indians, especially from UP and Bihar, who come to, you know, go to different states like Gujarat, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Telangana and Kerala for, you know, finding labor actually, because they have lots of problems in their states. So they actually come to these states which are more prosperous comparatively to UP and Bihar in search of work. Now constitution permit them to do so, but when they come to Maharashtra or some different parts, even in Karnataka, you know, you might have heard about that incident which happened four or five years before, when some through social media some hatred messages were sent, you know, against these people from Northeast, and suddenly they left the Karnataka, flooding the trains. Within 2 to 3 days, they actually left for their home, right? So such cases are there, right? So why these cases are there? The feeling of that we belong to this region and this region belongs to us. So all the opportunities should be first given to us. No outsider should be allowed to come here and make a business. Okay, so you won't make business and you will not allow an outsider to do business, and that's how it is, right? But we have regional diversity, and regional diversity itself is not bad. See, it's a fact, whether you like it or not. A person, like, see, Ladakh is a region that is also part of India, right? And Saurashtra is a region that is also part of India. Now, Saurashtra is completely different from Ladakh, right? Nagaland is completely different from some portion of Bihar, right? Where the Kosi River actually, makes their life miserable. So, we have different regions. These regions have people with different mindsets, culture, their dressing patterns are different, their belief system is different, their values are different, but still all are part of India. You have to accept this fact. Again, there is a diversity of race, right? So we all know that, how we judge people from different region. Somebody from North India is different from a person of Northeast. When we say race, what do you mean by race? Race is, difference in the physical features, like the color, or hairs or nose. If these things are somehow different, then we say that person belongs to some different race. So in India, this race have not brought lot of negative problems, but still some are there. Like, even today, we judge Northeast people based on their look, their physical features. In this common language, we call them Chinese or Japanese or Korean, but they are actually Indian. But as their race is different, right? Their physical features are different. We treat them badly, right? So we see, trust me, diversity itself is not bad. When we try to judge people and when we create a feeling of hatred for them, then that's a problem. But otherwise, diversity in India is always been there, and still we are together. That's why we call it unity in diversity. So this feeling of pluralism, that okay, he is different from me, but that's completely fine. That's completely fine. He is Indian and we have this feeling of fraternity, that he is my brother or sister. That is there. Even though that is disturbed sometimes by some elements in the society, but still that is there. And because of that only, we are still united even today. Trust me, in one state of India, we have so much population which is equivalent to population of many countries. Many countries means, for example, population of United States of America is equal to population of UP. Right? So UP can be itself is a different nation. In fact, even within UP, they have different regions and lots of diversity within a state also. So can you imagine how much diversity we are having in India? But still we are one country. So we are going to discuss how we are different, still we are one, right? So that is what is diversity in India. Okay, so I hope you, I have given you few examples like race, language, religion, region, caste, how we are different from others, right? And all these features are there in one person, that he belongs to one caste, one religion, he speaks some language, he belongs to some racial characteristics, right? And then there is a community which share all these things, and it feels that different community is completely different from us, right? And it might create problems, but still, that's how it is. We are a country with diversity, right? So this is about the diversity in Indian society. So diversity is one of the major features of Indian society. Now let's talk about syllabus wise, what are other topics we are going to discuss. Now see, I'll just talk about every topic just in brief, right? Just to give an idea, like we talked about diversity in more detail, right? Because diversity is one major important feature, and it is not explicitly written in this syllabus, but it is important. It is important for you to understand that our Indian society is known for its diversity and more unity in that diversity, right? Now we'll be discussing about the social structure. Now see, I already told you about social structure when we discussed this example, right? See, we are in a society, but we are not isolated. They say to be is to be related. If I am there, I am related to someone. I am related with blood relation with my brother or sister, right? My parents are related to each other with the relationship of marriage, right? And their caste is same, because in India, intercaste marriage is still not preferred, right? So they have married because they belong to same caste. That is also known as endogamy, right? So when we talk about social structure, see, this word structure is important. When we say structure, we actually imagine something physical. Like for example, a flyover on a highway is a structure, right? A bed and a table in my room is a structure. What is social structure? Social structure is basically this mesh of relationship between an individual and a community. One community with other community. One region with other region, right? So if I am an individual, and how I am related to society in different means, different ways, that forms a social structure. That I am a student of the college, I am disciple of my teacher, I am son of my father, I am brother of my sister, right? I am member of this caste, I am member of this club or community, right? I belong to some region, I belong to some state. All this forms a social structure. Now what are the major components of this social structure? We have already discussed some of them, we'll just revise them. So one is caste, the most important one. Now see, as I told you in the start of the lecture, that you know, actually in India, this is not an Indian word. First thing, this is not an Indian word. Indian word is jati. Indian word is jati. Now as I told you in the start of the lecture, that when I take birth, a caste is associated with me without even my consent, right? Now see how important it is that throughout my life I have to live with that identity. Now see, if you were, you know, in front of me, I would ask this question to you, that in daily life, where actually we have to face this concept of caste? Like, when are the occasions, or what are the events when actually we face this? If we, you know, if you really think that you need to make a difference, pause this video right now and think where actually caste come in the picture in daily life. Caste is not something which I keep in pocket or I eat, but it is still part of my identity. But where actually it is there mentioned explicitly? Pause and think for a while and come back. Okay, I hope you have paused the video and you have thought for a while. If you think of simple examples with common sense, where actually I have to follow this? First I come to know about my own caste when I grow up, when I come to know about the things, my parents or somebody from my relative tells me that, "Are, we belong to this caste." and then we know that okay, there is something like caste. Okay, then first time we deal with caste when we deal with maybe caste certificate, like during schooling or during our education or you know something like that. So this reservation word comes with, you know, where we discuss caste actually. Then we discuss caste in most important event of our life, that is marriage. This caste is enemy for all those romantic lovers who really want to, you know, choose their own soulmate and live with that one. What will happen? I go to college, I like someone, and I, you know, then start dating that person. Now, do I have to see which caste him or her belong to? I just love that person. But now, back of the mind, I have that fear that I can't do that. If you are in Europe, you are very free to choose a person and you are sure almost that we can live together if we agree, if there is consent amongst two. There is no other problem. But in India, you, from the start of doing this, you fear that there is no future to this relationship because my parents are not going to agree. Why so? Caste. Caste is the biggest enemy of today's youth who really want to choose their own soulmate. Because if you go to your parents with this proposal that I love someone, they will say, go to hell. You are going to marry someone with our choice. And you maybe will be given some options, but the options provided by us. And you don't have a choice. Right? So marriage is something where this caste comes. Third factor, like there are many, many places where caste comes, but these are very popular, which we face actually in our life. Now this is politics. We know that even today, most of the politics in India is still revolving around what? Caste groups. That is also known as vote bank politics. Many politicians actually even today use caste for their political gains, and people do have caste loyalties and they vote for the leader belonging to their caste. How can we call it democracy? Big question. But still, caste is something which we actually face here. Do you agree with this? So this is one major feature about which we are going to study in the coming lecture. That will be in fact our first topic which we are going to discuss in the upcoming lectures, right? So this is caste which we are going to discuss. Then comes very close to our heart, which we are part of, and that is family. I told you initially only that the topics we are going to discuss in this subject especially are those which are very close to us, are those we with which we live actually every day. These are the topics which we actually are part of, and we take them granted so much that we don't even think about them. But we can't even think about our life without these things. Like say, talk about family. So what comes to your mind when I talk about, like talk this or say this word family? What? My parents, other siblings with me, that's it. Yeah, but is it so simple? No. You have to understand that how this family started. This family started with one more topic, which is again part of this syllabus, which is marriage. That my parents got married, right? And then procreation happened. I was born, my other siblings were born, and we are family. Now that is just one type of family. That is not the only definition of family. Even two brothers are living together, that is a family. If they are you know, connected with blood relation, that is a family. A woman who have adopted a child and living just with that child without marriage, even that is a family. Because family is by three means: by blood relation, by marital relation, or by adoption. Right? But this family is having lots of issues. दिस फैमिली इज हैविंग इशू ऑफ जनरेशन गैप. लाइक एज वी ग्रो अप अवर थॉट प्रोसेस चेंजेस, वी गो टू कॉलेज, वी हैव अवर फ्रेंड सर्कल, अवर वी थिंक दैट वी आर मोर लिबरल एंड अवर पेरेंट्स वी थिंक दैट आर कंजर्वेटिव एज कंपेयर टू अस. So their thought process and our thought process don't match at various events. But still, this is the only institution which stand behind us when we fail, when we are in trouble, right? This is the institution which actually gives me identity. Who am I? You know, people are like, "Acha, whose son are you? Whose daughter are you?" Right? So I get identity because of my father or mother or both of them, right? If we do something which we think is appropriate or whatever, but the first fear in our mind is if it will tarnish image of my family, what my parents will say, what my sister will say. So we have that in mind. So it is very important to us. It is the same institution in which there are problems too. So for example, domestic violence, about which we will talk, this is not something which we are going to discuss now, but we know that domestic violence is a problem which is within the family, that a newly married daughter-in-law might be harassed by their parent-in-laws or even by the husband. So that problem is also part of family only. Family, trust me, family is an institution, is universal. It is throughout the world and it is there in India too. But obviously we have again different values, different culture and different thought process. So it is interesting, very interesting to study what is family. I have discussed only few things about family. Now see, again this marriage, which is the base of family, because when two individuals marry, they form family. Now you can say, no sir, things have changed now and even people with living relationship can stay together and that is a family. I agree that. But we know that there are very few cases. And in country like India, actually, people go for living relationship, but they consider living relationship as a pilot project. They will stay for some years together and then they will marry, because they believe in the institution of marriage.